The RPG is a major weapon because it's portable and very destructive. One of them almost killed me in Afghanistan, and it would have done if it had gone off. This photograph's taken in Afghanistan. I was on assignment for Medecins Sans Frontières, and they wanted me to do a piece on the war, the forgotten war. It's originally shot in colour, and I prefer it as a black and white, but the slightly demonic look on the horse kind of feels that colour's the right medium. There's a sport there called buskashi, which is quite a violent sport. And traditionally, the headless corpse of a goat or a calf would be the ball. And the idea of the game, quite simply, was to get it across the line by whatever means are possible. When I was taking this image, everything was a bit chaotic. I mean, it's just before the game started. This guy on the horse in front is trying to sort of back me off. You know, Afghanistan was a great place to photograph until the Taliban came into power. So it was pre-Taliban days. And there was a civil war going on. I mean, basically various warlords were making sure that they kept control of their turf, which meant that they could rape the women in it, which meant that they could steal from the farmers. And the farmers were getting pretty pissed off, not surprisingly. And my experience is very simple, that when I do go to war zones, except for total war zones, life goes on. People get by. Sheep get herded in the rituals of summer and winter. Crops get grown, sown, cut, harvested. And I wanted to photograph that older Afghanistan. If you had a camera 2,000 years ago, you'd take exactly the same picture. Kids would be wearing what they're wearing. The sheep would look like this, the architecture would look like that. So I was keen to kind of try and get that nuance of the ancientness of the culture. You've got this dynamic that weaves around. He looks that way, he's looking back at me, then I'm back in the picture again. But it's got a strong, very strong diagonal going on with it, which is contradicted by this horizontal. And that sets up a kind of tension. Visual tension. And I think a lot of good photographs, interesting photographs, have a quality of circularity that they keep you bounced about inside the frame, and then you bounce outside and then you come back in again. This is only a fragment of what their lives are like. Hopefully I'll carry back with me. I was parked up beside the road with some kind of puncher, I think, and this truck went past. So I chased them around this hill a bit with a long lens. They're kind of wondering what this lunatic's doing. I'm not shouting at these people to look at the camera. I'm shouting at them not to look at the camera. And they kind of go around the bend of the road and off to war somewhere. You know, the fact is that they were like farmers with a classical, and they used it when they had to use it. The level of the skills were basically learned on the battlefield. You know, there's no nice army training system for 2 years. You get thrown in head first, basically. Like soldiers everywhere, just ordinary people who got caught up in it. They were sensible people. They had families at home. They wanted to get back in one piece. And I think you have to respect that. You know, I think it's a common thing amongst armies. They downplay, as it were, the dangers that they're going to go into. I don't expect to go to places like Afghanistan, where there's a major conflict going on, and get away lightly. This guy, for example, has got an RPG on his back, and then he seems to be holding one in his front as well. I was beating a retreat, along with some other media people, and then we heard this noise and hit the ground. There was an unexploded RPG head and it didn't go off. You know, running up this hill watching this, I had two young kids. I thought, I want to play football with them. I sort of decided that was the last conflict zone I was going to go to. Okay, let's start again.